Ginana nana bojo, ani giti mana tu, ishkote nene indigena kaz, bekeju nong and donjaba, minwa wawiyatu nong and donjaba, anamiki benese dodom, minwa djak dodom, anishna be endao, odawa endao, ojibu endao, badawadami endao, shani endao, shimaguj wabanong, jawanong, ningabianong, giwed nong, aki, gizik,
we have just reached the spring equinox under the sugar bush full moon. I want to share a story about the thunderbirds as they return. Some of our thunderbirds live in Thunder Bay Mountains in the Great Lakes area near Lake Superior. The thunderbirds are supernatural, powerful manitous, and manitous means spirit in our language. And they can create rain, wind, and thunderstorms with their wings and eyes. These are gigantic birds that protect the Anishinaabe, the original people of this land we also call Detroit. They have the ability to cause thunderstorms. They make thunder by heating their brilliantly colored wings and light the skies with their lightning bolts that shoot from their eyes. They're said to take their storm south in the autumn, the fall, and return with them in the spring. And we hear. The Thunderbird was created by Nana Bojo to help fight underwater creatures and to protect humans against evil spirits. As spirits of the sky realm, Thunderbirds were links between the spirit and physical world. They're sacred to us. When the lightning strikes again in the spring, it is a ceremony to wake the spirits back up from the spring and return the birds to bring Wabanomiquan, which is that sacred light path from the east, and bring it in position so we can walk that path before we reach winter again. Thanks for listening to this Atazokan, which means the sacred spirit of the story. Much love, and my name is Knox, and I'm from the Thunderbird clan. Miigwech.